Hey, and welcome back. Been starved for content here during this COVID lockdown, but I picked up this two of these GoPro 7s, and I thought I would do an underwater test. I'm gonna actually do a couple of tests for you with a Sony action cam FDRX 3000 and a GoPro 7 Black. I made this little mount for them. It's weighted and sits on the bottom so I can photograph fish. But I need to rinse it off, and I need to rinse off my face with some fresh water. And then I'm gonna walk over here. They've now got a path that you can hike all the way down and around to the lighthouse. So I'm gonna take the other GoPro that hasn't been underwater with me today. No microphone, we'll just use the natural sound on the camera. Let's see what that looks like. We've got some dust coming in from the Sahara Desert today, and the heat index is supposed to be 105, but I'm gonna go for a walk now. When I get back, if I'm too hot, I'll jump in the water again or run over to the gym and take a cool shower. So let me rinse off and then we'll head out. By the way, I did a video on this natural area here at the lighthouse. You might want to check it out. Link's right there. Oh, I guess back in last summer, last fall, something like that. It's a cool area. It goes on the back here, and then there's a pavilion. I'm going to walk on the other side today where the lighthouse is. I've been wanting to go over here and hike this for a while. I said I was going to do it when it was cooler, but I'm wearing wet clothes from diving over here from snorkeling, and I can always go back and jump in the water again or head over to the gym. This is the video I told you about that I made earlier. The link's somewhere up there. You can go see that if you want. So I got across the road here. There's a lighthouse in the distance. Well, let's go for a hike and see what's going on. Boy, once you get out of the ocean breeze, it gets so hot in Florida. Now, I'm from Florida. I've been around it all my life. It's beautiful over near the beach. But boy, if you get away from it, it's just punishing. Years ago, there used to be a bunch of a one-way sign. That's pretty bizarre. Anyway, I started to tell you, years ago there used to be a bunch of Australian pines right along the intercoastal here. And there were some rope swings there. It was really cool. And I was over here one afternoon with my son. He was actually playing on the rope swings with some of his friends, and I was snorkeling over under the bridge. And one of the guys that they were with on the rope swing got hit by lightning. I had to take him away in an ambulance, and of course my son was just a few feet away, so they were all frazzled as well. But anyway, I can hear a little intercoastal noise up here, so looks like we should be coming out of the native scrub here and back over to the intercoastal. Another one-way sign. You can probably hear that sound back there. Those are cicadas. Boy, does that remind you of summer in the south. Really something else to hear. There we go, we're back in the breeze now. Now it's cool. Not a cloud in the sky. But today it's going to be really, really hot. The dust from the Sahara is supposed to be reaching us. So, well, here's some fresh mulch. These are papaya trees. These are actually females. They'll have fruit later on. You can tell the flowers are up real close to the stalk there. And these flowers right here, these are periwinkles. They come in two colors. There's the most common one, and then they grow in white as well. And there is a one of our ficus trees. That's not a native variety, but it gets spread by birds. The native variety of ficus tree has very big, broad leaves. Here's some more papayas. Now this one's got male and female growing together. Let me see if I can get over here and show you the male flowers. No, I'm not going to be able to get in there. That's a native gumbo limbo tree. Oh, look at the papayas. They're all in here. Okay, this is pretty cool. It's a little bench here in the shade of this ficus tree. Let me see if you can see that. And then there's some steps going up here. This section used to be called the sand hills. And it started eroding badly. And then, of course, people always get out of control with their drinking and everything. And this was originally all Coast Guard property. So I'm kind of surprised that it's even open. But anyway, hey, this is a mountain in Florida. Got to take them the way you can get them. That's it. Highest location in Palm Beach County, probably. Okay, this is pretty cool. Hammock hangout. So they've put some posts here and rings. You can hang your hammock here yourself. Hammock hangout. Pretty cool. So there's three posts, that's interesting. You can go from here down to there, or over to there, or over here. Oh, I see, you could do it. Yeah, three people could get in here in a triangle. Pretty cool. So we're kind of getting into a Florida hammock. Yeah, here you go, here's the sign. Before they made this an official pathway, we used to walk through here getting down to the sandhills to go play. Used to bring my dog Buddy down here. Administrative access only. Okay, so we're right out. Now this is the section they used to call the sandhills. Let me sneak over here and get some footage for you. Thank you. So there's the Jupiter Lighthouse. Nobody up on it. It's probably still closed because of this silly COVID. That's Jupiter Island over there. One of these houses probably cost you between $5 and $8 million. That's Du Bois Park over there. I do a lot, I spend a lot of time there. In fact, there may be a little Du Bois Park time in my schedule for this afternoon. So we're gonna get to climb right up here to the base of the lighthouse. Let me turn the camera around so you can see it. Pretty cool, huh? It was built in 1860. I used to be a docent there, and I used to keep the, when they'd bring the tours, I would be the guy that stayed up at the top, because the older folks that would do the tours didn't want to make the climb, and I like to stay up there so I wouldn't have to go up and down. I could just stay up at the top. You count the number of people. Down at the bottom they say, okay, we're sending 32 up, and you count them when they get up there. And assuming nobody jumps, you send them back down and say, I'm sending 32 down. It's really beautiful up there. I've got a video on this channel. I'll put the link here up above. I don't think you can do video tours anymore. Now we've got, as Yogi Berra said, when you come to a fork in the road, take it. So now I don't know where we're going. But the footage would be cooler if I go this way. I know this is not the best camera to show you the lighthouse up close. I didn't want to hike in here with the excuse me, piece of protein bar caught in my throat. I didn't want to hike in here with the big camera until I saw what was going on. I think what's happening is I'm going to come out at the back of the parking lot. That lens was taken down during the Civil War and taken to Key West, where they hid it from the, I guess, from the Union troops. Oh yeah, I'm down at the end of the parking lot. Hid it down in Key West from the Union troops. It's called a Fresnel lens. I think I heard it can be seen. Oh, I know it could be seen miles. I think the horizon is 8 miles away. Unless you're going that way, and then it's always 8 miles away. I think the horizon's 8 miles away. And I know this could be seen way out there. That lens is really cool. All lighthouses have two things. They have a color pattern, and they have a flashing pattern. So this is an old French color. Got the paint in France when they painted the thing. And the flash pattern, I believe, is you see the first one, and then 7 seconds later you see the second light, and then 22 seconds later the first one comes back around again. So you're supposed to be able to identify where you are by the color and the flash, flashing pattern. So I think the next lighthouse north of here is up at New Smyrna Beach, and I think it's red and white striped. But I would say that if you had to identify where you were by the color of the lighthouse, you stand a good chance of being lost. One way. It's interesting, it's one big loop. I think this is a tamarind tree. If you know, if I'm wrong and you know, put it down below in the comments. There's a big bracket fungus. My son, who lives in Raleigh, forages for mushrooms, so he's an expert on fungi and mushrooms and the like. Patrick, if you're watching this, Why don't you identify that fungus for us and put it down in the comments? Okay, so it looks like we're heading back away from the water and out of the breeze. Oh, here's something else. Let me just show you this. This is called green tip cocoa plum. There's two varieties of it. There's a red tip and a green tip. That's the fruit. Starts very really easily. See them all over the ground. I've got it growing in my yard, but I've got the red tip one. It's a little prettier. There's also two kinds of palmettos. This is the other one. In that other video of mine, I showed you that's the green one. This one has like a blue. Look here. Here's a good example of it. Look at the color there. This is a blue color. I think it's a subspecies. Looks exactly like the other one, except that it's got that blue color to it. Let me show you. Here's the sea grapes. Here they are right here. They're not ripe. When they're ripe, they turn a burgundy. And they're actually edible. Or you can make tea out of them. But they have a really big pit, and they're very, very, very tart. I happen to like them, but I never see anybody picking them and eating them. Here's a bench. Another bench, okay. And let's see here. I wonder where those... Oh, those condos are over on... Those condos over there on Jupiter Island. I'm really turned around here. Okay, so I'm facing northeast now. This pine tree right here, that's one of those sand pines. If you saw my video on the Hope Sound National Wildlife Refuge, you saw some of those. There's the link is right there up in the left-hand corner. They're really cool. See how they lean over? Here's one right here. You can see they've got really small needles on them. Really cool. They look completely different than our slash pines. And these little oak trees in here, these are, I think they're called scrub oaks. They never get really big. But boy, when you see them, you know you're in some hot territory. Prickly pear cactus. Let's see, you've seen this before in my videos. I'm pretty sure the Latin name, the Latin genus of that is Opuntia or Opuntia, but they call it prickly pear, and it gets a beautiful, beautiful yellow flower on it. Really, I mean, just stunningly beautiful. About 3 inches across or something like that. But also, all cactus set fruit. They get pink fruit that are kind of like the texture of watermelon inside, except that they are white or pink. I think a lot of Spanish and Caribbean people eat the cactus fruit. I never have. Doesn't look too appetizing to me. I probably won't do that. While I'm just walking along here, let me pose a question to you GoPro experts. I bought two brand new GoPro 7 Black. I tried to buy them from GoPro, but they screwed the thing up, so I had to buy them at Best Buy. I shot a bunch of footage last Friday, and it all came out fine. On Saturday, a ton of footage from both cameras. Let's see here. One way. Oh, okay. A ton of footage from both cameras was corrupted. I was up at the boat parade for President Trump in Cape Canaveral, and I shot a ton of footage, and it all, most of it on Saturday, the day of the parade, was corrupted. So if you know what I might have done wrong, put something down below, or if you know a good software program that can recover corrupted files, I'd appreciate that too. Hey, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good. I've been using the Sony action cam for a couple of years, and I'm pretty comfortable with that. And I've only had one file ever get corrupted on that. Hey, how you doing? And you know, there's one of Murphy's laws is whatever can go wrong will go wrong, and it'll go wrong at the worst time. So I shot 384 files, including one of a historic trailer. 383 of them are fine. The only one that was corrupted was the one I needed. Hey, how you doing?
Good.
So this tour of this vintage, restored vintage trailer was corrupted. Okay, we're back. There's the lighthouse. Here's the Singer Island Outdoor Center, Jupiter Outdoor Center. We are back out. I happen to have the only parking space around here with any shade. So let's head over there and get the car. Okay, well that's it. That's the tour. It's gonna feel great to go to the gym. Hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, you might consider subscribing or leave a comment down below. Maybe there's something else in the area you want me to check out for you. I've lived here almost 30 years. And you might consider subscribing so you don't miss other videos. So until the next one, have a great afternoon.